viewers if they think there's anything disgusting in that.
As part of the anniversary celebrations and an initiative to find new talent for the millennium, BBC Two Scotland now presents a collection of short films made by members of the public, reflecting the past 75 years.
The data links are set to give Scots internet access to American cable networks. With dozens of other channels available, the government's set to axe cultural funding for regional TV.
Somebody call an ambulance.
The BBC was rushed to hospital today after collapsing in the street. A spokesman for the company denied suggestions that at 75 he was unfit to continue working.
This is the Scottish programme.
I think it would be helpful if you could tell me what, in your view, the meaning of life is.
Well, there's a big one for you.
My time, my space. Don't shoogle the accumulator, said with elation, or you'll shake up every station. Wireless, television, internet. Man's thirst for knowledge, barely wet. Early days, the goons, the glums. Earlier still, the wartime dums. Dum, 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 dum. Music adapted to thwart the Hun. Coded music, not for fun. BBC with worldwide coverage. English spoken. Malcolm Muggeridge. Ying Ting Yakarapu Spurton. Drama. Under Milkwood. Burton. Financial disaster. The Wall Street crash. Wiped us out. Depression. The backlash. The Empire Exhibition. King and Queen. Very grand. Knee on Dad's shoulder. Flag in hand. King George's death, Edward to reign, fate stepped in to rule again, abdication solemn and bland, Edward and Simpson hand in hand. 30s, teetering on the brink, Chamberlain, Hitler, salute, don't think. Clydebank Blitz, bombs raining down, slaughtering innocents, bloodied ground. Evacuation, shunted out of town, frantic scramble, gone to ground. Holocaust, atom bomb, rations, nylon stockings, new look fashions. Greenham Common, the pill, the coronation, women's voices rebuilding the nation. 60s people, flower power. Vietnam War, napalm shower. Musical London in all its glory. Kismet, Hair, West Side Story. Festival of Britain, showtime at last. Wartime behind us, an icy blast.
Had a bit of a fall.
Pressure's too low. We need to move. God, do you see who it is?
Yes, and yes, come on.
On the coast.
Into her lonely cottage every night comes music played 100 miles away, and as she hearkens, unto her it seems that she is one with the vast listening throng, held wrapped together by the strains of song, made one in music, dreaming the same dreams.
This is the national program from London.
Today we have with us in the studio Newton Tweedsdale, art critic of The Onlooker, J. Wallace Larwood, book critic of The New Politician, and Faith Bradshaw, film critic of The Sunday Sun.
Oh, I see. I'm not terribly interested in that. Let's try another station, shall we?
Little Miss Bouncer, a loves an announcer, a down at the BBC.
She doesn't know his name, but how she rejoices when she hears that voice of voices.
Good evening, everyone. This is Henry Hall speaking.
I hope you're listening, because it would be a bit daft if I was talking and you weren't.
We're now going over to Adelaide to listen to the test match between England and Australia. The English team is now batting. England's captain, Mr. Jardine, is now facing the bowling of Grimmett. Well, lovely shot, sir.
Keep fit, take exercise, keep fit, and you'll be wise, that's it. Grow twice your size, whatever you do, keep fit, keep fit. Now take the air, don't sit. In your armchair you'll get no medals there, whatever you do, keep fit.
Tonight we have a special surprise for you. Mrs. Darius Potts is going to tell you about her magnificent flight.
I suppose you'd like to know what it feels like to be over the North Pole. Just a British mother alone with her baby. I just had to do it. Of course we couldn't see the North Pole. We were flying blind. Clouds and everything. But somehow I just knew we were there. Of course, I used Mary Oil, lubricating oil.
Excuse me, Mrs. Potts, we cannot have advertising.
I'm so sorry.
Put on your earphones. Tune on your set.
listening at 3:30. Sit well back. We're going to have a crack from Auntie Aggie of the BBC.
May I take this opportunity of thanking you very much for the wonderful reception you've given to the band. Goodbye, and here's to the next time.
All alone again, listening to that voice on the radio.
Control 2298, now have your location, please.
Yep. Inbound now. ETA about 5 minutes. The patient is about 70, 75. Flaps for chest pains. Better have someone from cardiology on standby for this one. Make them earn their money.
On the coast.
I was a child of the 80s, the decade of the yuppie. Football violence still plagued our game, and British football was in slow decline.
The year I remember most in the 80s was 1986. This is my story.
As a boy, I moved from a stable life, living in an Edinburgh estate, to a remote town with limited resources. The upheaval made me very uptight and insecure. I found it hard making friends at my new school. The one friend I still had was football, but the team I loved played miles away, and money and my age prevented me from going to see them. This is how BBC Radio came to be my true friend in a time of crisis. I lay on my bed, dreaming endlessly of sitting in the stadium and watching my beloved Hearts playing a beautiful game. All around were reminders of the team I loved, but I couldn't go and see them. I picked up the Radio Times and began to flick through it, looking for the weekly listings. The radio pages caught my eye. 12:03, Gardener's Gold.
If you're going to improve the quality of your soil at this time of year, you need a really good, rich manure. There are several excellent commercial brands, but you really can't do better than the well-rotted horse manure. Just the Joby.
103, Tommy Troon's Highland Tunes.
This next record is an old favourite of mine from the old Cala days at Ullapool Town Hall. It's been requested by Cheap Frey Inverness. And what a timeless classic it is.
Then I saw it, 202, Sports Sound. I frantically tuned the radio, and there it was, mid-commentary on a vital
here
league game.
Hearts, starting to push forward once again, Cahoon, twisting and turning. Past one, past two, still it's Cahoon. Midway inside the Rangers half now, passes to Robertson in the edge of the box, there's a chance of a shot, a goal! Hearts are really back in the game now, another wonderful, fierce shot by the Hearts goal king.
In that moment, all the stories I had read as a child made sense. Dreams really can come true. I've a newfound confidence now, and I've moved back to my beloved Edinburgh. I've not forgotten my old friends though, especially my radio. And when I go to a game now, I take it with me.
And it's a wonderful atmosphere here at Tynecastle with just 20 minutes to kick off in this vital cup tie. Fans are still pouring in from the McLeod Road entrance for what promises to be a wonderful afternoon's football. A mass of maroon and white in the stands, what a great sight.
Okay, we'll meet him there then.
Heart attack. Lived through so much, the depression, the war years.
This is the BBC Home Service.
This morning, the British ambassador in Berlin handed the German government a final note.
Closing of places of entertainment. All cinemas, theatres, and other places of entertainment are to be closed immediately until further notice.
This country is at war with Germany.
dinner. From the menu, soup, roast beef and green peas, and apples and cream, it might have been a crossing to Cherbourg in peacetime.
We've been getting a lot of letters from listeners who advise cooking with steamers and two-tiered sauces, if you have one.
It was a room full of men on the way, wondering, waiting, and listening.
The Battle of France is over. The Battle of Britain is about to begin.
Now, what we're going on with this morning is the use of the respirator and a gas attack. Now, the first thing you would do is you'd hold your breath. The reason being, if you didn't hold your breath, you'd breathe in the poison gas and you'd be gassed.
Men will still say, this was their finest hour.
Well, now the Germans are dive bombing the convoy up the sea. There's one going down on the target now. Bomb. No, missed the ship. There's one coming down in flames and he's going slap into the sea and there he goes. Smash!
German aircraft carried out a number of attacks on Great Britain last night.
My sister, Margaret Rose, and I feel so much for you. As we know from experience what it means to be away from those we love most of all.
Well, that carol came from some of the men of the 8th Army, and it was sung from the borders of Tripolitania. We are a good way at the moment behind our forward troops, who certainly won't be done without caroling tonight.
But how are you today? How's the stomach? Is it firm and steady, or somewhat warm, or a little wobbly and a trifle windy? Or was your Christmas day so Spartan that today you're fighting fit with no twinge of remorse?
Certain kinds of cooked bacon will soon be available without coupons. Here is the news, read by Richard West. Paris has been liberated.
Yesterday morning, General Jodl, the representative of the German High Command, signed the act of unconditional surrender to the Allied Expeditionary Force.
Scientists have made the atomic bomb at last.
At the time of the explosion, we were wearing Polaroid welder's glasses. And the explosion was so bright that it had the same effect as if night had been turned into day.
We're back now in Piccadilly Circus. It's after midnight here in London. It's crowded as it's never been crowded before. And as for the noise of it, well, listen for yourselves to Central London DJ Roar.
Age. Sense of consciousness?
Not much.
How's it looking? That's... Okay. Let's get inside.
Doubt at all that young people are being provoked and titillated and excited sexually.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed. It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Thank you.
Sometimes I get pissed off and I want to get loaded, and I get loaded.
Wheel two, room four. Where's the consultant?
On his way.
Apparently.
On his way. He'll be watching television. We'll see him when casualty finishes.
That'd be ironic. Killed off the television.
Very apt.
Smoking, drinking, drugs. It's a depressing catalogue. Many of the patients I see have led a life which sows the seeds for their own death.
Along the coast.
Are you ready?
The world ended simply with an unheeded crack. The crowd, watched in silence, faces white, tears held back.
Oh, turn it off, Neil!
No, this is really good, this, Mike. Oh, Vivian! I was just getting into that.
I'm bored and deserve to die! This is the end! Armageddon! No future! Bastard!
I see a world where the only activity people are engaged in is the viewing of other lives, fictional lives, lives that, if they have any basis in reality at all, are merely shadows of a place that existed before the consuming cancer in the corner of each living room took a grip, growing with the birth of each new channel, multiplying, reaching out to take a foothold in every interest that we have, every emotion we display.
We laugh with it, cry with it. If our heart's bound, then it will be because the beast's heart is bounding, because nothing in real life offers the suspense and excitement given us daily by our supreme master. If there is hope, it is the hope that tomorrow night's programming schedule will better tonight's, which itself threw up some of the most breathtaking, utterly hypnotic rubbish I've ever witnessed.
The wind blew through gently in sound beats of three, thinking how empty its life now would be. It rhymed through the clouds its sadness that day that its God-faced young children were going away, that its slow dreaming children would be blown away.
Where would we be without television?
We don't know. We don't care. But by the time we start considering the possibilities, the trailers have finished. The perfect poetry of it all, the sweet synchronism of multi-channel viewing induces an intense, almost sexual reaction. I'm like a junkie, overdosing, unable to move from my chair. BBC, I accuse it of being the bedrock of a medium which has swallowed us whole, kidnapped our lives. The initial signs of the cancer were its first broadcast. It opened the floodgates. Here comes the flood!
Television flickered gently, his cold, blue-laced face, aware that quite soon he'd mingle in grace with the sound of NICAM as it thundered and boomed from the sleek metal speakers, the black stainless wombs.
We are the instruments of our own self-destruction, pawns in the eternal game of ratings chess. So why don't we stop it? Because we want it. Because we need it. Could we switch off, get up, go outside and live? Why go outside and be the blood flowing through your town's dying veins? The box provides everything. We don't have to try now. Apathy rules here. To tape or not to tape? That is the question. Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer the pain and anguish of missing a program, or to take arms against a sea of troubles and set the timer.
The curtains were drawing, the cinemas were shattered, the demoralized stage crew had dispersed and scattered. Only these souls remained to see the conclusion, the swan song and bow of this ill-fated illusion. Prologic and widescreen, miraculous fusion. I thank you.
Television, you are poison, but you are comfort. You are a window to the end of reality, dressed up like a lovely day. I own you, but you own me. BBC, you gave us a bomb, gift wrapped. You gave the beast in the corner of the room power.
Charge for 300.
Ready.
Clear.
No response.
Along the curve. Mín am niach farin seoghad an nimmol. Siesu eit ar cliach iorpa is a vúd. Ach am eir ád fatin as gairna siit. Eit ar da dúlachas caidrón dana helu. Vill na BBC krúla kunna hela nin show. Ami fækin ervein vo sulanile. Agus er son trashak, ami na misk sluinjónur, na misk behanjónur mar farshu. Gan enyam cacadach na mochúasan. Mach talan von is gynialach na chairoam. Ach a iavéan úra djertag na mochúlan. Iavéan vo scalan na BBC. Chile Gohin Mar Kokrich, Achle Chile and Darn Shellav, Eichner Chech Nathohin, Jan Kultur Akanheen, Ta Shellavamacher and Dill, Troy Program in the BBC. dúnagan lá a mi mar a bhámi ag an doisioch, le seán chánan an tíne an t'mobíal, ach le scéalach an úr a fás salir an t'míndion. Sin an dáan a sealag a hánig úcan tra sealavish a BBC.
For 360.
We're trying to save a life, not make toast.
Charge for 360, please.
Ready.
Clear.
Yes, we have a pulse.